أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، خصوصا على افضلهم وخاتم النبيين محمد الامين وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. اما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى كما ورد في سورة الانعام: اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولقد ارسلنا الى امم من قبلك فاخذناهم بالباساء والضراء لعلهم يتضرعون. فلولا اذ جاءهم باسنا تضرعوا ولكن قست قلوبهم وزين لهم الشيطان ما كانوا يعملون. فلما نسوا ما ذكروا به فتحنا عليهم ابواب كل شيء حتى إذا فرحوا بما أوتوا أخذناهم بغتة فإذا هم مبلسون. فقطع دابر القوم الذين ظلموا والحمد لله رب العالمين. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم ربنا ألهمنا رشدنا وأعذنا من شرور أنفسنا. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى، آمين يا رب العالمين. Dear brothers and sisters and sons and daughters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. By the grace and blessing of Allah, we are starting our study today with ayah number 42 of Surah Al-An'am. In the four ayat that I have just recited, a very important divine law regarding the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been explained. The institution of prophethood, and for that matter, the institution of messengerhood of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has come to an end in the person of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But it had been a very important institution throughout the human history. And there are certain laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding this institution that were immutable, could never be changed. One of the laws was that whenever a messenger was sent to a nation or a group of people or a community or some region, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in order that they should wake up from their slumbers, sent to them small afflictions, small chastisements, so that if you know, because of abundance of food and abundance of everything, because they have gone away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they have gone to deep slumber, they might, you know, wake up from their deep slumber. But you know, if the nation that was to be doomed, you know, and they never responded to these small chastisements from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then after all these things, the final verdict of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came, and then there was no concession for such people to whom a messenger had been sent, who had made everything absolutely clear. There remained no doubt now for any sincere person who wanted to know what is right. There could be no difficulty now. So then the nation was eliminated, totally annihilated. That is called Azabul Akbar, when the whole nation was annihilated. And this is what happened to the people of Nuh, to to people of Hud, to people of Saleh, to the cities to which Hazrat Lut was sent, to the people of Shu'aib, to the Aal Fir'aun, and so on. This has been the divine law. Now this is the divine law which has been given in very brief one ayah in Surah Sajda. وَلَنُزِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. We will give them small punishments, small chastisements before the final and the big exterminating chastisement or punishment. Maybe that they wake up from their deep slumber and they return to us in repentance and, you know, asking our forgiveness. So this is the law given in these four ayat. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمَمٍ مِّن قَبْلِكُ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we sent our messengers to so many nations before you. فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْبَعْسَاءِ. We seized them with misery, وَالضَّرَّاءِ and distress. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَضَرَّعُونَ. So that they may be humble towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They may turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَوْلَا إِجَاهُمْ بَعْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا. Then why did not, when such afflictions came to them, why didn't they humiliate? Why did not, they showed humbleness towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَلَكِنْ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. But their hearts had already hardened. Hardened to that extent that even these chastisements could not wake them up from their slumbers. وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And Satan had made what they were doing very beautiful for them. Well, we are doing very good deeds. We are prospering. We have very good civilization. Our culture is very high. We are holding high position. All these things, you know, they made them stick to their wrong paths. And even these smaller chastisements from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which were sent to wake them up from their slumbers, they couldn't wake them. فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ. Now this nasu here doesn't mean nisyan in the means of forgetting something. Because there we can find in another ayah of the Quran, إِنَّا نَسِيْنَاكُمْ كَمَا نَسِيْتُمْ لِقَا يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا. So nisyan here means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can never have anything, you know, like forgetfulness. Nisyan here means to ignore. Just, you know, turn away. فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ. When they ignored all that with which they were admonished, we sent them our ayat, we showed, we gave the messengers the miracles also, everything came to them. فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ. Now they just ignored everything. فَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ أَبْوَابَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. Then أَبْوَابَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. And then we opened the gates of all blessings on them. Okay, if you are going that way, go. And we give you more to eat. We shall give you more to enjoy. Hatta idha farehu, when they were rejoicing, then their slumber was deepened instead of being rising from their deep sleep. Faidha farehu utu. Bima utu, what we had given to them, akhaznahum baghtatan faizahum mublisoon. Then we seized them suddenly. And then they were in despair and frustration. Faqutia dabirul qawmi allazeena zalamu. And then the roots of that nation, evil doing nation, was cut off. The roots were cut off. This is, you know, final punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That the whole nation is done away with. There are so many modes of expression in the Quran for this also. When we find, you know, فَكَلَّمْ يَغْنَوْ فِيهَا. Those people now, it appeared they never existed. When the people of Nuh were finished and annihilated, exterminated, it seemed that they never lived on this earth. When this nation of Aad was eliminated, now you could see their dwellings, you could see their palaces that they had built, but not the people who were living in it. Kallam yagnaw fiha. They became as if they were never living in these cities and towns and regions. And another mode of expression, la yura illa masakinuhum. Now you can see only the dwellings in which they were used to dwell and live, not the people, not the dwellers therein. So this has been a law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the messengers. But this is not the law for the prophets. This is only for the messengers. And this is agreed upon among all the scholars and, you know, the mufassirin of Quran, that prophethood is general. Messengerhood is special. Every messenger must be a prophet also. But every prophet is not a messenger. Prophets who were not messengers, they were just like the awliya Allah, the very pious people living among the men. But you know, to them was coming wahi also. Revelation was coming. But they were not appointed specifically to a nation. But when a prophet was appointed specifically, go to Fir'aun. Izhab ila Fir'auna innahu tagha. Now with this special appointment, now he became a messenger. وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ هُودًا. Specific appointment. To the people of Aad, we sent from their own brethren, Hud. وَإِلَىٰ سَمُودًا أَخَاهُمْ صَالِحًا. So actually when a prophet is appointed, just as we have, I don't know what is the case here in Pakistan, there is a cadre of civil service. Somebody has qualified to be CSP. Now he can be appointed as a deputy commissioner somewhere. So that is an appointment. But his cadre remains, he is a member of the CSP. Then there is a lower rank and that is PCS. These ranks remain the same. But the appointments can change. He can be appointed as deputy commissioner somewhere, or some deputy secretary in the central government and so on. So that is appointment. Prophethood is the cadre to whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending his revelation. Maybe he has not been appointed for a particular people. He will be living. You can have the example of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu was salam. He never called that, just believe me, aminu bi. He didn't put the condition to the king of Egypt, unless you believe in me, I am not going to help you out of all this, you know, catastrophe that is going to befall your country. No. He was a Nabi. He was a prophet only. Not a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the difference. Nabi and Rasul, there's a difference. And that is why I gave you these, you know, these ayat, they are the law. For there has been the, we must say, it has been the law. Because now this institution of prophethood as well as messengerhood has come to an end. This has been the law with the messengers. Whenever a messenger was sent to a nation, now there was no third alternative. Either you believe in him, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you all the blessings. If you reject the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now you forego your right of existence on this planet. You will be done away with. You will be exterminated. The whole nation annihilated. And that is, you know, the story of all these messengers, which is being repeated many a time in the Quran. What happened to the people of Nuh? What happened to the people of Hud? What happened to the people of Saleh? What happened to the cities to which Lut was sent? What happened to the people of Shu'aib? What happened to Ali Fir'aun? Why? This was the divine law. It must be remembered. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ سَمْعَكُمْ وَأَبْصَارَكُمْ وَخَتَمَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَعْتِيكُمْ بِهِ. Say to them, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just ponder over it. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes away your sight, your faculty of hearing, and if he puts a seal on your hearts, who is that God besides Allah, except Allah, who can bring back to you these faculties? Unzur kaifa nusarriful ayat. See how we are explaining our ayat variously, in various forms. Tasrif means to rotate a thing. One thing said in one style, then the same thing repeated in another style. If you couldn't understand it this way, well, this way and this mode might be intelligible for you. كَيْفَ نُصَرِّفُ الْآيَاتِ ثُمَّ هُمْ يَصْدِفُونَ. But they are turning away. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتَكُمْ إِنْ أَتَاكُمْ عَذَابُ اللَّهِ بَغْتَةً أَوْ جَهْرَةً هَلْ يُهْلَكُ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. Again, say to them, have you ever thought, if the punishment from Allah comes to you suddenly, without any notice. Bhakta means something happens without any notice. Aujaratan, an attack which comes openly and after giving a warning. Hal yuhlaku illa al-qawmul zalimun? Who will be destroyed and finished with except these people who are evildoers? وَمَا نُرْسَلُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ إِلَّا مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنْذِرِينَ. This ayah we have read in Surah An-Nisa also. رُسُلًا مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنْذِرِينَ. And I explained that these are the two basic functions of all the messengers, that they have to give glad tidings to the people who take to the right path. And they are the warners for those who don't take to the right path, who are going on the wrong path, despite all the warnings. وَمَا نُرْسَلُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ إِلَّا مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنْذِرِينَ. They don't come with some authority that they can perforce take somebody to the right path. As I told you, the most important example is that of Abu Talib. The Prophet ﷺ, how much he loved that he should embrace Islam. He said when he was dying, when Abu Talib was dying, "Oh dear uncle, please utter these words, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Maybe you utter these words in my ears, so that I can testify on the day of judgment that this uncle of mine had accepted Islam." But he refused. إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ وَلَاكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. O Messenger of Allah, O Prophet of Allah, you can't bring to the right path anybody whom you liked. This is the prerogative of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only He has the authority. He can, you know, turn the face of anybody in any direction. Because all the hearts, as I told you, according to a hadith, the hearts of all the people, they are between the two fingers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can turn them any way, to any side, to any direction. But this authority is not given to any other person. Not even the prophets. And not even the chief of the prophets, Sayyidul Mursaleen sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا نُرْسَلُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ إِلَّا مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنْذِرِينَ. And we don't send, and we don't, you know, raise our messengers, but only as the bearers of glad tidings and warning. فَمَنْ آمَنَ وَأَصْلَحَ. Now it is up to the people. Whosoever comes to believe, and he mends his way, أَصْلَحَ. فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَعْزَنُونَ. For them there will be no fear and no grief. They will never be grieved. وَالَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. The same simultaneous contrast again. And those who belie our signs and our revelation, ayat covers both the things. All the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, maybe the miracles, maybe all the signs, you know, in the heavens and the earth. إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. And then, you know, the revelations also, they are ayat. وَالَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. يَمَسُّهُمُ الْعَذَابُ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْسُقُونَ. Then, you know, they will be afflicted with the punishment due to their transgressing. قُلْ لَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ إِنِّي خَزَائِنُ اللَّهِ. This is another very important thing about the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They never claim that they have some extra authority. They had the powers to do anything they like. They have the power to show miracles on their own. No. What's the position? Just, you know, focus your attention on this ayah. We have different notions, you know. But what is the actual position of a messenger of Allah? What has been the actual position? If this is the position of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the final prophet and the last messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what to speak about the others? قُلْ لَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ إِنْدِي خَدَعِنُ اللَّهِ. Say, I have never claimed, I don't claim, I don't say to you, that I own the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا عَلَمُ الْغَيْبِ. And I don't claim to know the unseen, except the knowledge that Allah gives me. I don't know it on my own. The unseen is unseen. وَلَا عَلَمُ الْغَيْبِ وَلَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ إِنِّي مَلَكٌ. Nor do I claim to be an angel. I am also a man, a human being. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيَّ أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ. إِنْ أَتَّبِعُ إِلَّا مَا يُوحَى إِلَيَّ. I am only following what has been revealed, what is being revealed to me. This is my position. The only difference between you and me is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending me his revelations. I am also a human being. I don't claim to be an angel. I don't claim I have all the powers, all the authority of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I never claim that I can show you any miracle you demand. I never said it. قُلْ لَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ إِنِّي خَزَائِنُ اللَّهِ وَلَا أَعْلَمُ الْغَيْبَ وَلَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ إِنِّي مَلَكٌ إِنْ أَتَّبِعُ إِلَّا مَا يُوحَى إِلَيَّ قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الْعَمَى وَالْبَصِيرُ. Now, can they be who are seeing equal to those who are blind? Who can see the truth and who closes his eyes towards the truth? They can't be equal. أَفَلَا تَتَفَكَّرُونَ. So do you not ponder over these things? Don't you use your intellect? أَفَلَا تَتَفَكَّرُونَ وَأَنْزِرْ بِهِ الَّذِينَ يَخَافُونَ أَنْ يُحْشَرُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ. Again in this very surah we found in the beginning, أُوْهِيَ إِلَيَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ لِأُنْزِرَكُمْ بِهِ. Here again, وَأَنْزِرْ بِهِ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, go on warning them with this Qur'an. You warn with this Qur'an because you are a warner. You give the glad tidings through this Qur'an because you are the bearer of the glad tidings. وَمَا نُرْسَلُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ إِلَّا مُبَشَّرِينَ وَمُنْزِرِينَ. But these duties you have to perform through Qur'an. Read out to the people Qur'an. It is sufficient to guide them. If somebody likes to be guided, it is sufficient to guide them. There is no need of any other thing. So, أَنْزِرْ بِهِ الَّذِينَ يَخَافُونَ يُحْشَرُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ. Those who have some fear that they will be gathered to their Lord. They will be gathered someday. لَيْسَ لَهُمْ مِنْ دُونِهِ وَلِيٌّ وَلَىٰ شَفِيٌّ. And on that day, they will have no wali, no protector, no shafi, no intercessor against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will find none to protect you, none to intercede. Now about this intercession, we find two types of ayat in the Quran. Either there is categorical denial, no intercession, or there is an exception also, illa bi'izni. Man zallazi yashfa'u indahu illa bi'izni. With his permission, this is an exception. But absolute intercession and thinking that somebody has the power that he can change the verdict of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can came in the way of the verdict of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has some power over Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or he is so dear to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he will never reject his intercession. All these things, you know, they are false. Tilka amaniyuhum. These are the wishful thinking, you know, people have been having. And these amani were there among the Jews also, and these amani are here among the Muslims also. لَيْسَ لَهُمْ مِنْ دُونَهِ وَلِيٌّ وَلَا شَفِيٌّ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ. So that if you are warning them, maybe they have taqwa. They become conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They try to save themselves from the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the punishment of the hereafter. وَلَا تَطْرُدِ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاةِ وَالْعَشِيِّ. And don't drive away those people. You know, there was an objection of the chiefs of the tribes. Well, Muhammad, we want to come to you. But how can we come to you? We find that, you know, people who are very low in status, always they are sitting with you. These people are our slaves. Who is this Bilal? He's a slave. Who is this Yasir? He doesn't have the honor and respect of a Qarshi. He's an alien. But now you are always surrounded by such people, poor people. How can we come to your company? So you just turn them away. This has been a common thing. All the chiefs and all the, you know, the noble people, so to say, as they thought themselves to be, they said, we can't come and sit along with these people, you know, who are arazuluna badiyar rai. We can see that they are, you know, menials in our society. So this is the objection. Now, might be that an idea could have come to the mind of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If I just say that at this time, because, you know, the chiefs are coming, the noble people of Quraysh are coming, you don't come at that time. But this is, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been commanded here not to do it. ولا تطرد الذين يدعون ربهم بالغداة والعشي. Don't drive away those who call and pray to Allah, to their Lord, in the mornings also and in the evenings also. Yuriduna wajhahu. They only want to have the face of Allah. And what does it mean? If you are pleased with somebody, you are face to face with him. If you are annoyed, you turn your face away on the side. So they want the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yuriduna wajhahu. What does it mean? They are seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ma alayka min hisabihim min shay. You are not accountable for anything regarding their accounts. Wama min hisabika alayhim min shay. Neither they are accountable due to anything which pertains to you. You have to do your duty. You have to call people. All human beings are all equal. You call these people. Whosoever responds, now you must embrace him. You must give the attention to him. You must love him. Whosoever has responded positively to the call, maybe he's from the high cadre of the society, or maybe he belongs to the lower cadre of the society, it is absolutely irrelevant. فَتَطْرُدَهُمْ If you drive them away, فَتَكُونَ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ A very stern warning. Then you will become yourself from among the evildoers. Don't discriminate between these different levels, that only the high people can come to you, the nobility can come to you, and not these common people, whom they call the menials. وَكَذَلِكَ فَتَرْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ بِبَعْضٍ And in this way we try and test someone through someone else. I have made them belonging to the class of slaves, and made him, and I have made him, he was born to a chief of any clan of the Quraysh. I have done this for them so that I try and test you with each other. وَكَذَلِكَ فَطَرْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ بِبَعْضٍ لِيَقُولُوا أَهَؤُلَاءِ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ بَيْنِنَا So there these should say, this nobility would say, are these the people, the menials of our society? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed them, leaving us aside? Because if this is real blessing of Allah, then they are the blessed ones. How come? We are the chiefs, we are wealthy people, we are the strong people, we have all the things of this world, and if these are the people chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this Bilal, this Abbar, this Yasir, are these the people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed? Alas Allahu a'lama bishakirin. Is not Allah more aware of who is really grateful? Allah knows that Bilal is grateful to him. Allah knows that Yasir is grateful to him, thankful to him. Allah knows that Abu Jahl is arrogant. He might be a chief in his own place, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't you know, the criteria with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are different from the criteria that you have in your mind. وَإِذَا جَاكَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ Now, just focus your attention, please. Now, firstly, there was the commandment, don't drive them away. These poor people, these slaves, whosoever they are, if they have responded positively to your call, if they believe in Allah, if they call Allah evenings and mornings, if they also want the pleasure of Allah, you embrace them. Now, the positive side. وَإِذَا جَاكَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِآيَاتِنَا And when those who believe in our revelations come to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَقُلْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ You should welcome them with greetings. Salute them. Say to them, Peace be upon you. كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ Your Lord, congratulations. Your Lord has taken upon himself mercy. He will deal with you with all the mercy that he has. أَنَّهُ مَنْ عَمِلَ مِنْكُمْ سُوءًا بِجَهَالَةٍ And one manifestation of his mercy is that whosoever amongst you commits something wrong, something evil, due to ignorance. And jahala means in Arabic also, you know, emotional. A person who is emotional, not logical, not rational, he is also jahil. Ignorance as well as emotionalism. So in some emotional outburst, you know, If you, somebody has from amongst you committed something wrong, summa taba min ba'dahi, but then he repents. He turns his face again to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance. Waslaha, and he mends his way. He rectifies himself. The mistake that he committed, he rectifies it. فَأَنَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ This is the glad tidings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ghafoor, he is forgiving and he is merciful. وَكَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ وَلِتَسْتَبِينَ سَبِيلُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ And in this way, we are making our revelations explained. نُفَصِّلُ, تَفْصِيل. كَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ We are explaining our revelations. وَلِتَسْتَبِينَ سَبِيلُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ So that the way of the criminals, the way of the sinners should become absolutely clear so that the moment can avoid the ways and means and etiquettes of those who are sinning, who are unbelieving. قُلْ إِنِّي نُهِيتُ أَنْ أَعْبُدَ الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have been prohibited and forbidden. I cannot worship those whom you are calling besides Allah. There can be no compromise between you and me. They wanted a compromise. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says no compromise. وَدُّوا لَوْ تُدْهِنُوا فَيُدْهِنُونَ They want that you compromise somewhat, and they will also be ready to compromise. Some give and take, because they had reached the conclusion that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have not been able to stop his dawah spreading. Because this surah that was revealed, as I told you, in the last year, just 1 year or so before Hijrah. So during this time, they had tried all their means. They had persecuted, they had done everything that they could do, and they found that now it's impossible. You know, the advance and spreading of this message cannot be stopped. So they wanted some compromise. Okay, you should be lenient. You accommodate our point of view also, to some degree. Then we can have, you know, a compromise. قُلْ إِنِّي نُهِيتُ أَنْ أَعْبُدَ الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ I have been forbidden. I can't do it. I can't worship. I can't love. I can't prostrate before these deities to whom, you know, you are praying. قُلْ لَا تَبِعُوا أَهْوَاكُمْ Tell them, I cannot follow your wishful thinkings, your lusts, your desires. I cannot. قَدْ ظَلَلْتُ إِذَنْ If I do so, I will also go astray. If I take to your path, then I will also be doomed. وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُهْتَدِينَ And then I will not be from among the rightly guided people. I can't have any compromise with you. قُلْ إِنِّي عَلَى بَيِّنَةٍ مِّنْ رَبِّي See the self, you know, confidence, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants in a da'i he should have in his da'wah. Whatever is his position, he should have full confidence. قُلْ إِنِّي عَلَى بَيِّنَةٍ مِّنْكِ مِّنْ رَبِّي Tell them, I am on something which is absolutely clear and infallible guidance. Bayyana. What is bayyana? We say it in Urdu, bhai, bilkul bayyan baat hai. A thing which is absolutely self-evident. It's absolutely clear. It needs no additional proof. Bayyana. Qul inni ala bayyanatin min Rabbi. You know, I'm not groping in the darkness. I'm actually, my position is based on absolute bayyanat. These are self-evident truths which, you know, I have accepted. وَكَذَّبْتُمْ بِهِ And you have belied them. You are not accepting it, although it is absolutely evident, just as, you know, when the sun rises, aftab amad dalil-e aftab. When the sun rises, it doesn't need any additional argument that there is a sun. The sun is there, everybody can see it. That is bayyan. Aftab amad dalil-e aftab. Now these teachings which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down on me, for you, they are just bayyan. But you are denying them. You are rejecting them. وَكَذَّبْتُمْ بِهِ مَا عِنْدِي مَا تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ بِهِ I don't possess what you are hastening for. They used to say, for the sake of argument, okay, O Muhammad, we have rejected you. You have preached to us for 12 long years. We have rejected you. Now bring the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That was another way. To impress their people. But these people, you know, they are very sincere actually. Had they any belief in Muhammad, had their hearts and minds believed in Muhammad to any degree, they couldn't say this thing. Then now bring. We are ready. Bring the punishment. تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ بِهِ. But it is not in my power. It is not my authority. It is to be decided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That, you know, is not my authority. مَعِنْدِي مَا تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ بِهِ. I don't possess. I don't have to decide. Which you are hastening for, you are demanding. إِنِ الْحُكْمُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. Authority is wholly and solely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This here also, you know, the position of the messengers. It must be clear. They don't claim we have the authority. I can bring, you know, devastation and punishment and azab whenever I like. No. I am a humble servant of Allah. He has sent down the revelation. He has appointed me to convey the revelation to you. And that I am doing. It's nothing my business. It doesn't concern me. When he decides to punish you, actually it is up to him. إِنِ الْحُكْمَ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ يَقُصُّ الْحَقَّ وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الْفَاصِلِينَ. He is relating what is the truth. These ayat, they consist of the truth. Now he is conveying these things to you. وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الْفَاصِلِينَ. And he is the best of the deciders. He will decide when, you know, no more concession to you and the punishment should come to you, just as the punishment came to the people of Nuh, or the people of Hud, or the people of Saleh, alayhim salatu wassalam. قُلْ لَوْ أَنَّ Very natural. قُلْ لَوْ أَنَّ عِنْدِي مَا تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ بِهِ. Say to them, had I the power over what you are demanding, you are saying, bring this punishment. Why is that punishment is not coming? It means, you are a liar. It means you are not messenger of Allah. Had you been messenger of Allah, as you say, that the people of Hud, they were exterminated. The people of Saleh, exterminated. But we have been rejecting you for 12 long years. No punishment has come to us up till now. It means you are not a messenger of Allah. قُلْ لَوْ أَنَّ عِنْدِي مَا تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ بِهِ. Had it been in my power, had it been with me, the authority, لَقْوَضِيَ الْأَمْرُ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ. Then you know the matter would have been finished between you and me. I am also a human being. I am also fed up with your attitude. But you know it's not in my power. It's for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided. لَقْوَضِيَ الْأَمْرُ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ. It would have been decided long ago. But it is not in my power. وَاللَّهُ عَلَمُ بِالظَّالِمِينَ. And Allah very well knows all the evil doers. And He will deal with them. وَعِنْدَهُ مَفَاتِحُ الْغَيْبِ. See, now this is all Tawheed. And how, you know, clearly the distinction between Allah and His bondsman. Although Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the highest among the prophets and messengers. He stands next to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all the creation. All angels, everything. He is just next to. Ba'daz khuda buzurg tu hi qissa mukhtasar. After Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you are the supreme. But even he is in this position. As I quoted to you a saying of Ibn Arabi, Ar-Rabbu Rabbun wa in tanazzal, wal abdu abdun wa in taraqqa. Rabb remains Rabb, although he comes down to the first heaven every night, in the small hours of the morning. And the bondsman, the abd, the servant, remains the servant, although he went to the seventh heaven. Even there, he is a servant of Allah. He is abd of Allah. But you know, Rabb is Rabb. This distinction. وَعِنْدَهُ مَفَاتِحُ الْغَيْبِ. And actually, he owns all the keys of all the unseen. عِنْدَهُ. لا يعلمها إلا هو. Nobody knows them except him. All the ghaib, nobody knows. Although he has given some knowledge of the unseen to the messengers. A messenger and a prophet is only differentiated from common human beings because something has been given to him which is not given to all the people. Muhammad was shown paradise. Muhammad had seen, you know, the hell also. So all these things. Muhammad was meeting the angels. They also belong to the unseen. We can't see the angel. So some of the unseen is opened and disclosed to the messengers and prophets. But you know, not all. لَا يَعْلَمُهَا إِلَّهُ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. And he knows whatever is in the land and whatever is in the sea. مَا تَسْقُطُ مِنْ وَرَقَةٍ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُهَا. Not a single leaf drops down, but he knows it. He is all aware. مَا تَسْقُطُ مِنْ وَرَقَةٍ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُهَا. وَلَا حَبَّةٍ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْأَرْضِ وَلَا. And in the same way, no grain in the darkness of the earth. A grain, you know, you have sowed a seed. Now this is in the darkness of the earth. But Allah knows which grain is lying where. And when to sprout, when to become a plant, he knows it. وَلَا رَتْمِ وَلَا يَابِسٍ. And no wet or no dry, إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. But everything is in a clear record, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This Kitabul Mubin is actually the attribute of knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything is in the knowledge. Nothing is out of his knowledge. And this is the book. This is the book of record. And actually everything is recorded in it. وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ. And it is he who takes the possession of your souls during the nights. When you sleep, you are unaware of yourself. The self-consciousness has gone. Where has it gone to? Allahu alladhi, huwa alladhi yatawaffakum billayl. He controls, he possesses the souls of human beings during the night. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا جَرَحْتُمْ بِالنَّهَارِ. And he knows, what had you done during the day? ثُمَّ يَبْعَثُكُمْ فِيهِ. And after this night, he will again, you know, raise you up in the morning. You wake up. And that is why, you know, the Prophet used to make the dua when he opened his eyes in the morning, you know. When he woke up, Alhamdulillah allazi ahyani ba'dama amatani wa ilayhin nushur. This, you know, sleep is also a sister of death. It's very near the death. Because we leave, we don't have the self-consciousness. So that is actually something very near to death. That is why this word wafat, huwa alladhi yatawaffakum, wa huwa alladhi yatawaffakum billayl, wa ya'lamu ma jarahtum bin nahar, summa yab'asukum fi, li yuqda ajalum musamma. So that the ajl, the time which has been fixed for you in this world should be completed. If you have to live here 30 years, well, every night Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take the possession of your souls. Then, you know, again in the morning, he will return your souls to you, and you will be again, you know, a moving human being. So that period which has been assigned beforehand, that is completed. لَيُقْضَى أَجَلُ مُسَمَّى ثُمَّ إِلَيْهِ مَرْجِعُكُمْ. Then to him is going to be your return. ثُمَّ يُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. And then he will inform you of what you had been doing. You know, all the basic tenets and articles of faith are being repeated and repeated and repeated. I told you that is the main subject matter of the Makki surahs. Allah, His unity, His attributes, Akhirah, resurrection, judgment, day of judgment, then the Jannah, and you know, the Jahannam, the hell and paradise and heaven. These are the subjects, repeated, in different modes, in different styles. Ek phool ka mazmu ho to 100 rang se bandhu. That should be repeated, but not repeated in the same way or in the same words. Repeated. That is called tasriful ayat. We take various modes of expression. We change, keep on going, we keep going changing the modes of expression. Kadhalika nusarriful ayat. وَهُوَ الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ. And he is fully controlling you. Now this qahir, you know, actually whosoever is absolutely controlling. هُوَ الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ. Nobody can go beyond his authority. وَهُوَ الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ over his servants. وَيُرْسِلُ عَلَيْكُمْ حَفَظَهُ And he sends upon you guardians. Now these guardians are of two types. The angels. Number one, who guard our lives because that ajal al-musamma is to be completed. They are guarding you. You don't need any other guards. Allah is guarding you. No bodyguards. Because you cannot be killed before that appointed time. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent upon you the guardians. They are guarding you. They are your bodyguards. And secondly, they are guarding or recording all what you are doing and all what you are uttering. Alaykum hafaza. وَهُوَ الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ وَيُرْسِلِ عَلَيْكُمْ حَفَظًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ Till that time that the appointed hour for him comes, تَوَفَّتْهُ رُسُلُنَا Now, our messengers, now this means the angels of death, they will take the possession of their souls, وَلَا يُفَرِّتُونَ And they are not going to omit anything, commit any mistake. ثُمَّ رُدُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ مَوْلَاهُمُ الْحَقِّ And then they will be returned to Allah, who is their protector, and who is the true protector, and true guardian, and true sustainer. Mawlahumul Haqq, ala lahul hukm. Listen, to him belongs all authority. Just imagine how many times this is coming. Idil hukmu illa lillah. Ala lahul hukm. وَهُوَ أَسْرَعُ الْحَاسِبِينَ And he is the swiftest in taking account, in reckoning. He will not need much time to prepare your balance sheets of what you earned, what you lost. He will, in no time, he will reckon. And in no time, he will take all the accounts of all the people. قُلْ مَنْ يُنَجِّيكُمْ مِنْ ظُلُمَاتِ الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ تَدْعُونَهُ تَضَرُّعًا وَخُفْيَا Ask them, who rescues you from the darknesses of the land and the sea? Tadurahu, you pray to him, tadarruan, humbly, wa khufya, and secretly. Oh Allah, you know you are riding a boat, there is some storm. Now, oh Allah, just save me this time. Then you know, I'll mend my ways. I'll do nothing wrong. تَدَرُّعًا وَخُفْيَا In your hearts you are calling him. قُلْ مَنْ يُنَجِّيكُمْ مِنْ ظُلُمَاتِ الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ تَدْعُونَهُ تَدَرُّعًا وَخُفْيَا لَيْنَ أَنْجَانَا مِنْ هَذِهِ لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الشَّاكِرِينَ If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saves us from this, then we should become, you know, very grateful to him. And we should act as grateful people, thankful people. قُلِ اللَّهُ يُنَجِّيكُمْ Tell them. It's only Allah who saves you, who rescues you. مِنْهَا وَمِنْ كُلِّ كَرْبٍ And from all the distresses that may befall you, ثُمَّ أَنْتُمْ تُشْرِكُونَ But then, when you are saved, then you start making shirk with him. Then you start calling other gods and goddesses and Aliha and Manat and Lat and Uzza. Now you forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and now you are prostrating before other deities. قُلْ هُوَ الْقَادِرُ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَبْعَثَ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابًا مِّنْ فَوْقِكُمْ This is a very important ayah. And we must, you know, read in between the lines. Where do we stand regarding this ayah? قُلْ هُوَ الْقَادِرُ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَبْعَثَ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابًا مِّنْ فَوْقِكُمْ أَوْ مِنْ تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِكُمْ أَوْ يَلْبِسَكُمْ شِيَعًا وَيُزِيقَ بَعْضَكُمْ بَعْضَ بَعْضٍ Three modes of punishment in this world. Say to them, He is all powerful, Huwa al-Qadiru, ala an yab'asa alaykum azaban, that He may send upon you a punishment, a chastisement from over your heads. Aw min tahti arjulikum, or from underneath your feet. Might be there's a big earthquake. And you know, underneath your feet, From there, azab of Allah, punishment of Allah is coming. And the third mode, أَوْ يَلْبِسَكُمْ شِيَعًا, or he may throw you into confusion and divide you into sects and groups. أَوْ يَلْبِسَكُمْ شِيَعًا وَيُزِيقَ بَعْضَكُمْ بَعْضَ بَعْضَ, and taste and make you taste the tyranny of one another. Kill each other. We don't need to send something from the heaven. We don't need to bring out something from the earth, from underneath your feet. If you are fighting each other, it's also the third and the worst form of punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ هُوَ الْقَادِرُ عَلَىٰ أَن يَبْعَثَ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابًا مِّن فَوْقِكُمْ أَوْ مِّن تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِكُمْ أَوْ يَلْبِسَكُمْ شِيَعًا وَيُزِيقَ بَعْضَكُمْ بَعْضَ بَعْضٍ. انظر كيف نصرف الآيات. Again the same word, تصريف الآيات. Look, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, how we are using the various and different modes to explain our revelations. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَفْتَهُونَ, so that they might understand. وَكَذَّبَ بِهِ قَوْمُكَ وَهُوَ الْحَقِّ. Now you look to the decisive style here. وَكَذَّبَ بِهِ قَوْمُكَ, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, your people have belied this thing, this revelation, this Quran. وَهُوَ الْحَقِّ, although it is the truth, the total truth. So, but it means they have committed the crime. Now they deserve punishment. It's our mercy that we are withholding their punishment up till now. But they have deserved. وَكَذَّبَ بِهِ قَوْمُكَ وَهُوَ الْحَقِّ قُلْ لَسْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ بِوَكِيلٍ. Tell them, I am not any guardian for you. I won't be able to save you from divine punishment and chastisement if it comes to you. لِكُلِّ نَبَيْ مُسْتَقَرْ. It's a different story that for every event, for every news, there is a time fixed in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you say, bring that punishment, I can't bring. Even if I want that the punishment should come to you, well, my wishing is also not decisive. Had it been in my power, the matter would have been settled between you and me long ago. This is neither in your power nor in mine. But it is in the hands of Allah. لِكُلِّ نَبَيْ مُسْتَقَرْ. For every news, there is a time fixed. فَثَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ, and then you will see and you will know yourself, for yourself. وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ الَّذِينَ يَخُوضُونَ فِي آيَاتِنَا. And when you see people who are meddling with our revelations, they used to mock at it, scoff it, and so on. But this is the instruction to all the Muslims which was given. And we read this ayah in Surah An-Nisa also, and this ayah was referred. وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ الَّذِينَ يَخُوضُونَ فِي آيَاتِنَا. When you see people, they are meddling with the revelations, فَعَارِضْ عَنْهُمْ, you turn away from there. Don't sit with them. حَتَّى يَخُوضُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِهِ, until they are engaged in some other discourse. Then you can come to them. Because you can't leave them, you know, forever. You have to convey the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you can't part from them permanently. Hatta yakhudu fi hadithin ghairi. Vaimma yunsiyannaka shaitan. And if Satan makes you forget, you are sitting with them, they are meddling and joking about the Prophet of Allah or the ayat of Allah, and you just didn't remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded me to go away and not sit there. وَإِمَّا يُنْسِيَنَّكَ الشَّيْطَانُ فَلَا تَقْوَدْ بَعْضَ الزِّكْرَ. When a recollection comes to you, when you remember, now don't sit for another, even one second, مَعَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ, with these people who are evildoers. وَمَا عَلَى الَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ مِنْ حِسَابِهِمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. And definitely, people who have fear of Allah, who are conscious of Allah, who have accepted Allah, who love Allah, on them there is no responsibility of these people. If they are going astray, they will face their whatever, you know, punishment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them. It's not on you. You will not be brought to the book regarding them on their account. وَلَكِنْ ذِكْرَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ. But this is a remembrance. This is admonition. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending these ayat to remind them. Maybe that someone of them, they take to taqwa. They become muttaqi. They become God conscious. They mend their ways. وَذَرِ الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا دِينَهُمْ لَعِبًا وَلَهْوًا. And you leave alone these people who have taken their religion as only لَعِبًا وَلَهْوًا, a play or an amusement. They don't take their religion seriously. We can find people today also. They are not serious about religion. And such was the case about those people also. They thought that they believe in these and these and these things, but they were not very serious about these things. وَذَرِ الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا دِينَهُمْ لَعِبًا وَلَهْوًا وَغَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا. This life of this world has deceived them. They are deceived by this life, fully occupied by it. As Allama Iqbal says, kafir ki ye pehchan ke aafaq mein gum hai, aur momin ki ye pehchan ke gum usme hai aafaq. A kafir is lost in this universe. He just loses the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is engrossed in this creation, in this world of matter. But a mu'min, he lives in this world, but he rises to a higher level of consciousness, and he is always conscious of the Creator, of the Rabb, of the Master. Actually, this is the difference. غَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا وَذَكِّرْ بِهِ أَن تُبْصَلَ نَفْسٌ. And zakir behi, now third time note, zakir behi, this pronoun behi, what is it alluding to? Quran. Zakir behi, try to remind them with this Quran. As you know, the last ayah of Surah Al-Kaf, zakir bil Quran man yakhafu wa'id. Tazkir, you know, sermons, remindings, they should be through Quran. This is the best reminder. Who can have a better reminder than the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You don't try to make your own long speeches. There's no need. That is why we don't find very long speeches of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even in the khutbah of Jummah, he used to recite Quran. Wherever he went to preach, he recited to them the ayat of Quran. This is the best mode, the best vehicle of conveying the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَذَكِّرْ بِهِ, and remind them with this. أَنْتُمْ صَلَى نَفْسٌ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ. Lest the soul of a person should be ruined due to what it has earned. لَيْسَ لَهَا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَلِيٌّ وَلَا شَفِيعٌ. And again the repetition of the same thing. For that soul, human soul, there is no wali, protector, وَلَا شَفِيعٌ, no intercessor. As I told you, somewhere you find absolute categorical denial of no intercession whatsoever. وَلَا شَفِيعٌ وَإِنْ تَعْدِلْ كُلَّ عَدْلٍ. And if you want to ransom yourself with paying some fine, etc., it will not be لَا يُخَذُ مِنْهَا, it will not be accepted from it. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ أُبْسِلُوا بِمَا كَسَبُوا. They are the people who have been ruined due to their earnings, whatever they have earned, their deeds. لَهُمْ شَرَابٌ مِنْ حَمِيمٍ. For them will be the boiling water for drinking. وَعَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And very painful torment بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْفُرُونَ, due to the kufr that they had been doing, due to the rejection of the faith and belying of the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ أَنَدْعُوا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَنْفَعُنَا وَلَا يَضُرُّنَا. Say to them, should we pray to and call to those deities besides Allah, leaving alone Allah, who cannot benefit us, nor can they do us any harm? This Lat cannot benefit you. This Uzza cannot benefit you anything. Nor they can do you any harm. أَنَدُوا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَنْفَعُنَا وَلَا يَضُرُّنَا وَنُرَدُّ عَلَىٰ عَقَابِنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَانَا اللَّهِ. And do you wish that we should also be turned back on our heels when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided us to the right path? Because they were pressurizing the Muslims. You come back to the deen of your forefathers. Why have you gone away from the beliefs of your forefathers? Your forefathers used to pray to this Lat and Uzza and Manat and so on and so forth. Why have you left them? قُلْ أَنَدْعُوا. Say to them, should we call and pray to those who cannot do any benefit to us, no good to us, neither they can harm us? وَنُرَدُّ عَلَىٰ عَقَابِنَا, نُرَدُّ عَلَىٰ عَقَابِنَا, and we should be turned back on our heels. بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَانَا اللَّهِ. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the right guidance. كَالَّذِي اسْتَهْوَتْهُ الشَّيَاطِينُ فِي الْأَرْضِ حَيْرَانِ. Like those, like the one whom the Satans have lured to bewilderment in the earth. Though he has companions, لَهُ أَصْحَابٌ يَدْعُونَهُ إِلَى الْهُدَىٰ أَتَيْنَا. Though he has companions beckoning him to guidance, saying, تَيْتَيْنَا, come to us. قُلْ إِنَّ هُدَى اللَّهِ هُوَ الْهُدَىٰ. Guidance is the guidance of Allah. وَأُمِرْنَا لِنُسْلِمَ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And we have been commanded to submit to the Lord of all the worlds. Now this simile is very good. Because in Makkah, there were people also who were calling towards Allah. And there were people who were pressing them to go back to their ancestral religion. Now in this condition, we have people who are calling us to Allah. We have Muhammad, we have Abu Bakr. They are calling us to the right path. How can we go back and go back on our heels to that religion of the past, which was possessed and professed by our forefathers? وَنَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَالتَّقُوهُ. And that you establish the prayer and have taqwa of Allah. وَهُوَ الَّذِي إِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. And he is the one to him to whom you will all be gathered. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number, 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.